First, we give honor to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the one who is head of our life. It's just another opportunity, it's another day that the Lord has blessed us as we come to study out of God's eternal word. And we seeking and asking him to give us the wisdom, the knowledge, and the understanding we need that we may be able to rightly divide God's word. The word of God is true, but it must be placed in its right order and timing. God is the God of time. This message today that we getting ready to go into is not concerned of the church. It ain't got nothing to do with the church. This is the other part of God. When we talk about God, we talk about one who is not only a God of love, but he's the God of wrath. And sisters and brothers, we're going to deal with the wrath of God. Amen. And this, at this particular time, the church is gone. Amen. We're going to be going to glory. And then the 7 years of great trials and tribulation. And God gonna be there. Jesus is the one, amen, who gonna open the seals. Those 7 seals that gonna be open. That they're gonna be the 7 years, and it gonna get worse and worse. And this last 7 years, the last 7 times that this is open, talking about this seal, it gonna be worse than any other seal. So we don't want to frighten nobody to make them think this is dealing with us. This, I come on talking this much about this now. This don't have nothing to do with the age of the church, the body of Christ. He come at this particular time in our time to seek and to save that which is lost. But whenever the seal time come, when he gonna deal with the seal, he coming, amen, sister and brother, not in love, but he coming in wrath. This same God that come in love, he coming in the time of wrath. And we need to recognize that fact. God is good and in mercy endures forever. And we want you to note out of God's eternal word, the 5th chapter of Revelation, starting at the 1st verse. And as we start in this great book, we asking us to look at 2 sides of God. Let's look at God with 2 sides. God of love and a God of wrath. Amen. He come first to save everybody. But sister, brother, the time of wrath is going to be a different story. And we must recognize that fact. Let us bow our head in the word of prayer. Father, as we come before you, we come humble, we knows how. We come knowing nothing but Jesus and him crucified. We come looking to the hill from which cometh all of our help. For we declare all of our help come from you. You the author, finish of our faith, and you are able to do what no other power can do. And as we enter into this book of Revelation, ask the Lord to give us the wisdom, the knowledge, the understanding that we may be able to bring forth these words that will be pleasing in thy sight. And we're going to give you all the honor, and we're going to give you all the praise for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. The book of Revelation, we want to start at the 5th chapter of the book of Revelation. And we're going to move on to the 5th and maybe the 6th chapter of the book of Revelation. This is the last years, amen, of great trials and tribulation is beginning. Amen, at this book. Amen. At this time, the church is gone. This is not dealing with the church, but this is dealing with Jacob's trouble. Talking about the Jews. Amen. And all the world that is left down here. This is not the devil doing. This is God. We talk about God as a God of love, and He is. But He also is a God of wrath. We Christians don't want all of God. Sometimes I hear people say they want all of God. You don't want all of God. You want the God of love. But you don't want God wrath. To get God wrath means you are lost. Amen. And you don't want that part. We want the love part. And we can get that love part only when we accept Him for our personal Savior. Amen. The event gonna come, sister and brother, because God has said so. And see, we have to put all of our confidence in Him. Let's go to the book of Revelation, book of Revelation, the fifth chapter and the first verse. It read like this, and I saw in the right hand of Him that sat on the throne. Amen. Maybe I need to pause here. Who is this sitting on the right, amen, on the right hand, amen, that sit on the throne? The one sitting on the throne is God. Amen. A book written and on the backside sealed with seven seals. Let me go back over it again. I saw in the right hand of Him, God, that sat on the throne, a book written within and on the backside sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel proclaiming with a loud voice, who is worthy to open the book and to loosen the seal thereof? Amen. They looked everywhere. Everywhere. They couldn't find nobody. How you know that, Atkin? The Bible tell us so. Amen. The Bible said, and no man in heaven, nor in earth, nor under the earth was able to open the book, neither to look thereon. It was a closed book, and nobody knew what was, amen, was in this book. And then John, who the writer of this book, he began to speak then. He said, and I wept, the fourth verse, and I wept much because no man was found worthy to open and to read the book, neither to look thereon. Amen. This book was a book of judgment. Amen. For everyone at that day that would not believe and accept Jesus Christ for their personal Savior. The Bible tells us, and we move on down to this fifth verse, and one of the elders, amen, said unto John, weep not. Mm-hmm. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the root of David, amen, have prevailed to open the book and to loosen the seven seal thereof. Who is this Lion, the Lion of the tribe of Judas, the root of David. Who is this? This is none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. He is worthy. Amen, sister and brother, to come and open the book. Nobody else was able, but Jesus, he prevailed, amen, to open and to loosen that book. Amen. Let me go back now, all the way back to the fifth verse again. Amen. And one of the elders said unto me, weep not. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. Talking about none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the root of David, have prevailed to open the book and to loosen the seven seals thereof. Amen. Let's move on down here, our sisters and brothers. Amen. And behold, and lo, in the midst of the throne. Amen. And of the four beasts, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb. Amen. Reckon who is this lamb? This lamb is none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. As it have been slain, amen, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, sent forth, amen, into all the earth. Amen. Sisters and brothers, of what we see now, we talk about a time, we ain't seen nothing. There's nothing comparison what's going to happen under these seals. Amen. And they're going to come, sister and brother, but don't you worry about it, because we won't be here. Everyone who has said yes to Jesus, amen, we are going to glory, and we won't be here at this particular time. Let's look at this seventh verse here. And he came and took the book out of the right hand of him, out of the right hand of God, amen, that sat on the throne. Jesus took this book out of the hand of God. Amen. The Bible tells us, as we move on down to this eighth verse, and when he had took the book, talking about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the four beasts and four and twenty elders fell down before the Lamb, fell down before none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, having every one of them harps, amen, and golden vial full of odor, which are the prayers of the saints. Amen. The prayers of the saints, sisters and brothers, they're going to deal with the prayer of the saint after the saints, amen, is already in heaven. So our prayer is going to be answered. God going to see to that, even in the trying and the tribulation period. God have a way of doing things, sisters and brothers. And we move on down to this ninth verse. And they sung a new song, saying, thou art worthy. Talking about none other than our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thou art worthy to take the book and to open the seal thereof, for thou was slain. What this talking about, thou was slain? When he hung on the cross of Calvary, he died for the sin of the whole entire world. He did it because of one word, love. The Bible said, God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believe on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Amen. The Bible tells us, amen, and having redeemed us to God. How did he do it? Amen. According to the scripture, sister and brother. Amen. By thy blood. When Jesus shed his blood for the sin of the whole entire world. And it's not his fault. Amen. Because man won't accept him because he died for the sin of the whole entire world. The Bible tell us, amen, of every kinman. Amen. And tongue and peoples and nations. Amen. And have made us into our God kings and preachers. Amen. God can do what he want to do. He is God, and everything he do is right, sister and brother, and we shall reign on the earth. Who is he talking about reigning on the earth at this particular time? He talking about his, the king, amen, the Jews, amen, sister and brother. And as I was going down to this 11th verse, and I beheld, and I heard the voice of many angels round about the throne and the beasts and the elders. And the number of them were 10,000 times 10,000 and thousand of thousand. Amen. Nobody can number this number. Amen, sister and brother. This is going to be a time that never have been before. But what he is doing, he is preparing himself, sister and brother, for the wrath of God to pour it out on the children of disobedience. Amen. We need to examine ourselves, make sure that we are saved, because, sister and brother, if not, then we might just be in that number at this particular time. But you put your confidence in him. He'll save you, amen, at this particular time. And we ain't got to worry about it because we're going to be going up to be with the Lord. Saying with a loud voice, those, amen, 10,000 and thousand, amen, listen at this, sister and brother. They are saying with a loud voice, amen, they are saying, worthy is the Lamb. Who is this Lamb? This Lamb is our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. That was slain to receive honor and glory and blessing. Amen. Amen. Sister and brother, let's move on down to this 13th verse here. And every creature which is in heaven and on the earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea, and all that are in them, heard I sing. Amen. Everybody heard it, sister and brother. Amen. And what was the saying? Blessed and honor and glory and power be unto him that sent on the throne. Talking about God. Amen. And into the Lamb. Talking about Jesus now. Forever and forever. Amen. He getting ready to do something, sister and brother, that had never been done before. But we won't be here. We as believers who have said yes to Jesus Christ, amen, we're going to be already gone. Amen. Let's look at this 14th verse here. And the four beasts said, amen. And the four and 20 elders fell down and worshiped him that live forever and forever. Amen, sisters and brothers. And we move on down, amen, to this sixth verse, amen, sixth chapter here, amen. And I saw when the Lamb, talking about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, he getting ready to open the seals now. I saw the Lamb open one of the seals. Amen. And I heard as it was a noise of thunder. Amen. One of the four beasts said, come and see. Amen. Come and see this event. Amen. What finna happen? Amen. Under this first seal here. The Bible tell us as we go down to this second verse here. And I saw and beheld a white horse. Maybe I need to pause here. Don't you get carried away about this white horse, because the devil have a counterfeit. So now this white horse here is not, amen, Jesus. Later on you're going to find out when Jesus coming with a white horse. But this white horse here is not Jesus. Amen. And I saw and behold a white horse, and he that sat on him had a bow. Amen. This is the devil. And a crown was given into him. See, he didn't have nothing that had to been given to him. Amen. And he went forth conquering and conquer. Amen. This is the God using the enemy. Amen, sisters and brothers, to help wipe out this world system. Oh, I hope we can recognize that fact. Amen. God has a plan, and God's plan alone will work. But we don't have to worry about these things. Why? Because the church gonna be gone. Amen. This is the time of great trial and tribulation. Amen. And when he had opened the second seal, I heard the second beast say, come and see. Amen, sisters and brothers. This is a time like never have been before. And when it's all over, this seventh seal, then, sister and brother, it will never be again. Amen. And all that will not accept Jesus Christ for his personal Savior, sister and brother, what tragedy. Amen. What tragedy it is when a man live in this world and will not accept Jesus Christ for his personal Savior. Amen. These things got to happen, sister and brother, because God is a God of wrath. Amen. He first of all is a God of love. And he loving everybody and getting everybody a chain so they wouldn't fall under this category. Amen. Which we call, sister and brother, the thing that God dealing with those who will not accept Jesus Christ for their personal Savior. The Bible tell us, amen, and there went out, the fourth verse, went out another horse and was red. Amen. And power was given to him that sat thereon to take peace from the earth. Amen. What we are going through with, sister and brother, is nothing. Mm-hmm. Amen. In comparison to what's going to come on the face of this earth. It is coming, sister and brother, Amen. Because God said so. The Bible tells us, amen, and that they should kill one another. Amen. And there was given into him a great sword. Amen, sister and brothers. I hope we see this, sister and brothers. Amen. Let's go on down to this fifth verse here. And when he had opened the third seal, I heard, amen, a black horse. I think I'm right here. Okay. Is that right? Black horse. And he that sat on him had a pair of banners in his hands. Mm-hmm. Amen. Sisters and brothers, this world here that we live, amen, God got a way. God got a way, amen, of destroying the world and everything that is in the world gonna be destroyed. He gonna have it done, sister and brother. Listen at this. And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts saying, a measure of wheat for a penny. Amen. And three measures of barley for a penny. And see thou hurt not the oil and the wine. Amen. That's the only thing they were concerned about at this particular time, the oil and the wine. The Bible tells us, and we move on down to the seventh verse here. And when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast saying, come and see. Amen, sisters and brothers. This is a time that had never been. Amen, but it's coming. Mm-hmm. Amen. Where it coming at? On this earth, on this world in which we live in now, sisters and brothers. Amen. And I looked, the eighth verse, I looked and behold, a pale horse. Amen. Who is the rider of this pale horse, sister and brother? And his name that set on him was Death. Amen. You mean to tell me, sister and brother, this going to happen to this world in which we live? Yes. Amen. But we won't be living here. Those who have said yes to Jesus Christ. The Bible tells us, amen. Let me go back over this verse again. Amen. Let's go back to this eighth verse. And I looked and behold a pale horse, and his name that sat on him was Death. And hell followed, amen, with him. And power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth. What earth? This earth in which we living in, sisters and brothers. Amen. To do something about the people that were living on the face of this earth. The Bible said to kill with a sword. Amen, sisters and brothers. What we see now? Nothing. I hope we see this. Amen. Amen. And with hunger. And with death. And with the beasts of the earth. These things is coming, sisters and brothers. Amen. But it only coming to those that, amen, will not accept Jesus Christ for their personal Savior. Amen. Amen. This how come we need to examine ourselves. Make sure. I'm not talking about just member of local assembly. Amen. We need to make sure that we are saved. Because if we isn't saved, sister and brother, we might be the one who left down here. Mm-hmm. I hope we see the truth, sister and brother. Let's look at this ninth verse. And when he had opened the fifth seal, amen, I saw under the altar the soul of them that were slain, amen, for the word of God. Talk about those now who were slain because of their testimony, because those who said yes to Jesus Christ and they killed them, amen. And for the testimony which they held. And they wouldn't give up. This is the one who would be saved, sister and brother. And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long, O Lord, mm-hmm. holy and true, mm-hmm. dost thou not judge, amen, and avenge our blood on them that dwell on the earth? Amen. God has a plan. God has a way, sister and brother, and his way is very sweet. Amen. We have to go through with some things. Amen. We have to go through with some things, sister and brother, but what we are going through with now is nothing in concern about those things that will happen. But now he is dealing with those who would be saved. Listen at this 11th verse. And white robe were given into every one of them, and was said unto them that they shall rest for a little, amen, for a little season unto their fellow servant also and their brethren that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled. Amen. So it's going to be some down there going to be what? Saved. Amen, sister and brother, and they're going to be killed. And now he is saying, amen, more other one who would say yes to Jesus Christ shall be killed. Amen. The Bible tells us, and we move on down. If we move on down to this verse here, sister and brother, amen. And I beheld, amen, I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, amen, lo, there was a great earthquake. Amen, sisters and brothers, the earthquake that we see now is nothing in comparison to the earthquake that he is talking about at this particular time. So this earthquake, and the sun become black as sackcloth, amen, of hair. And the moon, amen, came as blood. Amen. When did this happen? When this earthquake come? Have we ever heard talk of this type of earthquake down here now? No. This earthquake down here now is nothing in comparison to this earthquake, sister and brother. This is a time of great crisis and tribulation. Amen. When this happened, sister and brother, what else happened? And the stars of heaven, fell into the earth. The stars that we see. Amen, that we see by now, sister and brother, it's going to fall, amen, to the earth, on the face of this earth, amen, even as a fig tree casts her untimely figs, amen, sister and brother, when she is shaken of a mighty wind. These things going to come, sister and brother. Amen. So we have to put what? All of our faith and all of our confidence in the Lord. Amen. The Bible tell us, as we go down to this 14th verse here, amen, and heaven departed, amen, as the scroll. Amen. Sister and brothers, what happened while heaven is departed? Because of the earthquake that coming on the face of this earth. Amen. When it is rolled, amen, together, and every mountain, amen, and island will move out of their place. Talk about because of this earthquake, sister and brothers, that gonna come on the face of this earth. The Bible tells us, as we move on down to this 15th verse here, and the kings of the earth, and the great men, amen, and the rich men, and the chief captain, and the mighty men, and every bondman, and every free man, hid themselves, amen, in the dens. Amen, the Bible said, and in the rocks of the mountain. Amen, and said to the mountain, amen, and the rock, fall on us. This is going to be a terrible time. Amen, fall on us. Amen, God have a way, God have a plan. Fall on us and hide us from the face of him that set on the throne. Amen. Why? For amen. And from the wrath of the Lamb. Amen. Amen. God have a plan. These things gonna come. Amen. But always remember, we won't be here. we owed him a praise for that great day of his wrath. Talking about God's wrath, man. Talking about the time now. We are not living in the wrath time. We are living in the time that God come to seek and to save that which is lost. Amen. The Bible tells me, let me go back over this 17th verse again. For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand? Amen, sister and brother. In that day, Jesus have a plan. Jesus have a plan, and God's plan, and God's plan alone will work. Sisters and brothers, amen, let us examine ourselves. Let us not just to be member of local assembly. Let us make sure, and very sure, that we have said yes to Jesus Christ, because he got his arm wide open now. He is saying, come unto me, all that are laden and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. He'll give us rest, sister and brother, but it ain't no rest coming to those who will not believe. Listen at what have already happened, according to the book, sister and brother, to those that would not put their faith and their confidence in the Lord. The Lord also going to deal with now, sister and brother, he's going to start dealing with the Jews. Amen. The Jews, amen, going to be down here. Let's look at this 7th verse here. Amen. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds, amen, of the earth, that the wind should not blow on the earth, nor on the sea, nor on any tree. It finna get worse than anything that I have already talked about, sisters and brothers. Amen. I saw another angel ascending in the east, having the seal of the living God. And he cried with a loud voice to the four angels to whom it was given to hurt the earth and the sea. Got to get worse, sisters and brothers. Amen. The third verse here is saying, amen, hurt not the earth, neither the sea, nor the tree, amen, till we have sealed the servant of our God in their forehead. Who he gonna seal? Amen. The 144,000 Jews. Amen. These Jews gonna recognize something. They're gonna recognize those who, amen, have pierced. The one who they had pierced, well, the one was the Messiah. And they're going to be saved. They're going to be saved at this particular time. Amen. Listen at this, sister and brother. This is talking about the Jews now. Amen. Who going through the great trial and tribulation. And I heard the number of them which were sealed. Amen. And there was sealed 144,000. Amen. Of all the tribe of the children of Israel. See, this ain't talking about us, is it? Amen. This is talking about the Jews who going through the crisis and the tribulation, and they're going to recognize the Jews as a nation. Now, amen, as a nation, don't know him, but they're going to look back on whom they have perished. Now 144,000 Jews, amen, going all over the world, and they're going to preach. What are they going to preach? The kingdom of heaven is at hand. Amen. These events coming, sisters and brothers, but ain't you glad? Ain't you glad, amen, we won't be here. We going up to be with the Lord. He is our everything, sisters and brothers. Amen. And he gonna deal with those men and these men are going to be saved. This 144,000 Jews saved men. And guess what? All they're going all over the world, amen, with all of the nationalities of peoples, amen. If they got to be trained to know how they talk, no, amen. Right where they going to get it from, amen. They're going all over the world, sister and brother, amen, and preach the kingdom of heaven is at hand. And so it's going to be a lot of people going to be saved at this particular time. But this ain't talking about the church. This is talking about the great crisis and tribulation period. And God's going to send those Jews out, amen, preaching the kingdom of heaven is at hand. God bless you. God bless you. Don't clock on the wall. Don't clock on the wall. And then I can know time for me to get out of here. But if you are enjoying this radio program, will you write me a letter sometime? Walter Atkins Jr., Post Office Box 1142, Tarver, North Carolina. This is Walter Atkins Jr. saying, amen. And amen.